Okay, welcome back to my class. We are discussing balance of payment. In the previous classes, we have already discussed the meaning and the components of balance of payment. Meaning, we have seen that balance of payment is a systematic record of all economic transactions between resident of a country and rest of the world during a period of time. We have seen that balance of payment is having two components. First one is current account and second one is capital account. Current account, we have seen current account records all transactions in terms of import and export of goods and services and unilateral transfers between resident of a country and rest of the world during a period of time. And next one is, let us see this capital account. Capital accounts, let us see, records all international transaction of asset. Let us see what is capital account. Capital accounts records all international transaction of assets. And asset is any one of the forms in which wealth can be held. For example, money, stocks, bonds, government debts, etc. So let us see, whenever there is a sale of assets to the foreign countries, if we sell any of our assets, suppose the real estates are sold or land or buildings are sold to the foreign investors or the foreign companies, then certainly what will happen, we'll receive the foreign exchange. When we'll receive the foreign exchange, certainly there'll be the inflow of the foreign exchange in our country. We'll receive the foreign exchange. Whenever we'll receive the foreign exchange, that will be entered into the credit side of the capital accounts. But let us see, whenever other side, when we will purchase the assets, when we'll purchase the assets into the foreign countries, if our company will buy the land, building, or let us see, any assets into the foreign countries, even the shares of the foreign countries are purchased by our individuals or our companies into the foreign countries, then certainly we'll make the payments. So payments on capital accounts will record it into the debit side. So certainly let us see, when we'll receive the payments from foreign countries, either in terms of borrowing or in terms of investment, then certainly it will be recorded into the credit side. And when we will purchase the asset into the foreign countries, when we'll make the investment into the foreign countries, then certainly we'll make the payments. So that will be entered into the debit side. So debit side and credit side, these are the two sides of the balance of payments of the capital accounts. So these capital accounts are further classified into different components. Let us see what are the components of the capital account. Components of capital accounts here. The first one is investment. So investment means foreign investment. You are knowing that the foreigners, they are making the investment in our countries and our companies, they are making the investment. Our people, the private sectors, are making the investment into the foreign countries. So let us see this investment. Here I have written foreign direct investment. Foreign direct investments, it is, suppose if the foreigners, they used to purchase the real estate, if they purchase the land, buildings in our country, if they used to set up the industries in our country, if suppose the multinational corporations are there, they used to set up the industries in our country, certainly what will happen, we'll receive the foreign exchange. And when we'll receive the foreign exchange, certainly there'll be the inflow of foreign exchange, and we'll enter into the credit side. Similarly, suppose Indian company, if suppose Indian company, they make the investment in foreign country, you take the example in China or Japan, in USA or UK, in other countries, if the Indian companies, they used to make the investment in foreign countries, certainly let us see what will happen, we'll make the payments, and that payments will be recorded into the debit side. So outflow of the foreign exchange are recorded into the debit side, whereas the inflow of the foreign exchange are recorded into the credit side. Here there is foreign direct investment, another one is portfolio investment. Portfolio investment, one example is given, foreign institutional investment, FII. So this is first one, first component is investment. The second one is external commercial borrowings. External commercial borrowings, under which the Indian government and the private sector borrow funds from world money market at a higher rate of interest. So what happened? Let us see. The Indian government and the private sectors, they used to make the investment, they used to borrow the funds from the foreign countries. So let us see, these funds, when we will borrow the funds from the foreign countries, then there will be the inflow of the foreign exchange and we'll enter into the credit side. But when we make the repayment of the loan to the foreigners or to the foreign government, certainly let us see, it will be entered into the debit side of the capital account. Another one is, third component is given, external assistance, which means borrowing from foreign countries under concessional rate of interest. Let us see, borrowing from foreign countries under concessional rate of interest. For example, government aids, intergovernmental loan, multilateral and bilateral loans, etc. So multilateral loans, means bilateral loans, intergovernmental loans, these are the different types of the loans which are either borrowed or which are, let us see, lended at low rate of interest for certain developmental work. So these are the three components of the capital account. First one is the investment. Investment consists of foreign direct investment and portfolio investment. Another one, second one is external commercial borrowing, ECB. This is called, and this is the borrowing which are made by the government as well as by the private sector. And third one is external assistance, which means borrowing from foreign countries under concessional rate of interest. And let us see these components. These are the entries of the capital accounts are explained in the form of, in the tabular form. I have written here this side. Let us see, there are two sides of the capital account. One is the credit side, another one is the debit side. Credit side means a positive side, and the debit side is negative side. Credit side means receipts, and debit means payments. So receipt means there'll be inflow of forex. Forex means foreign exchange. Outflow means this payments means outflow of foreign exchange. Let us see this investment from abroad. If there is the investment from abroad, if there is the FDI, foreign direct investment from the foreign countries, if the foreign companies, they come in our country, they make the investment in our country, so certainly the foreign exchange will come, then there will be the inflow of foreign exchange, and certainly it will be under, it will be entered into the credit side. So this is inflow of foreign exchange. Investment to abroad, if suppose Indian company, they used to make the investment into the foreign countries, certainly the there will be the outflow of foreign exchange, and this will be entered into the debit side. Another example, let us see, we have taken borrowing from abroad, if we borrow from abroad, so the borrowings, let us say, from the foreign countries will be entered into the credit side, and lending to abroad will be entered into the debit side. Here, repayment of loans by the foreigners, repayment of loans by foreigners, let us say, if the foreigners, they used to make the repayment of the loan, if suppose sometime if they have taken the loan from India, then there'll be the inflow of foreign exchange. But if repayment of loans to foreigners, if Indian government taken or the suppose the private sector has taken the loan for commercial purposes, some profit purposes, and if they return the loan, then certainly will make the payment and there'll be the outflow of foreign exchange. So if you take the sum total, then this side, this credit side, this will be the capital receipt, and debit side, it will be the capital payments. So if this capital receipt and capital payments both are equal, then we can say there is capital account balance. So capital account balance, but let us see, this capital account balance is not balance always. So receipt and payments are not equal. So certainly, let us see, sometime if capital receipts are greater than capital payments, so certainly it is called surplus in capital account. I have already written capital receipts greater than capital payments, then this is called surplus in capital account. If suppose capital receipts are less than capital payments, or we can say capital payments are more than the capital receipts, then there will be deficit in capital account. So I think the concept of this capital account is clear to all of you. Okay, thank you.